everybody and welcome on my YouTube channel. You are with Alandris and now I will test for you the two new legendary heroes who has been released on the test server. It will be Vengeance Spirit and Enchantress. If I find her, Enchantress, where she is? She is there. So, in all case, I will show you the item. I will show you which stage you have to farm to get the item. And for sure, I will show you the skill and the effect in a little fight. So, let's begin first of all with Vengeance Spirit. You can see that unfortunately, my Vengeance Spirit is level 110 and red 4. I couldn't change anything. You could release the hero like that on the test server. So it's little pity because most of players actually are level 106, 107. And in this case, you will be red 3 with 4 items and not red 4. It's not important, we will have already an idea about how much damage he can do and if the skill will change a lot this hero, who is already not bad at all. So, the item, Scale Armor, Vengeance Spirit's special gear, Agility 60, Attack Damage 100, Armor Penetration 25, and for sure, when you will enchant it, you will get 120 of Agility, 200 of attack damage and 50 of armor penetration. So already we can see that the item without the skill is interesting. Agility, damage and armor penetration, it's really good for this hero who is a pure damage dealer in multi-target. We will check the skill now. I didn't push the skill at level 110, so you will have the value for level 107. I think it's more interesting for us actually. The new skill is Bloody Pupil. Nazira increases her own armor penetration and attack speed whenever she casts a skill. Increase armor penetration by 267.5. I really think that this skill is nice. And we don't see how much attack speed is increased. Like usual, Yukul is giving half of information that we need. But only the armor penetration, it's already really nice. 267, it's not ridiculous at all. So if we have armor penetration plus attack speed, I think it will be really useful. We will test it right now with one little fight. I have no guarantee about the quality of the team that will be on the other side, but at least we will have one idea of the damage. So we will begin with one damage test. So 26,000 by arrow, even when it's not the front line. Oh la la. I think her damage are just insane. She will perhaps success to kill a Shadow Shaman who is not the reference as the hero for the survivability for sure. But it's pretty nice to see that with Cleric, with reducing the physical damage, she success to kill Shigeti. It's crazy. I'm really curious about the amount of damage. I'm accelerating the fight a little bit. So you see that she has an eyes over her head when the skill is activated. It's always, in fact. 3 seconds. Okay, so now the statistic of the fight. 1,600,000. Oh la 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 la. It's just crazy, crazy, crazy. Okay, in front we have nothing with moving, just a wall with receiving damage, it's true. But 1,600,000, it's pretty crazy. So, we will see in a real situation. I'm interested to see what she can do against Master Mage team. If she can kill the team before any ultimate. So, a classical Master Mage composition in front of me. I have some burst. Oh là là. I get the taunt. I don't know if I will survive. Oui, oui. I'm alive. Hop, it's finished, I think. Pouf! This damage! It's insane! 30,000 by arrow for everyone! 351,000 for a really short fight. You can watch 32,000 for Sorceress. It's just a joke. And even Thunderbeast, who have a crazy burst, do only 100. So this legendary skill will be really interesting. Don't forget another time that my hero is level 110, full red 4. So it will be little less than what you see actually. But anyway, it seems to be really interesting. So, let's speak now about the second one, Enchantress. Enchantress is one hero that I crazy like. Unfortunately, due to her low survivability, it's difficult to use her in the actual metagame. This hero has 50,000 HP and no way to increase this amount of HP because in the training field you will get magic power, magic crit and magical resistance. So you will have one hero with low HP, low armor and low magical resistance. Even if with the training field the magical resistance is not so bad, it's difficult for her to shine in the metagame. Now, the item. Darkstaff, Enchantress's special gear, intelligence 60, magical power 130 and maximum HP 2000 with enchantment 120 of intelligence, 260 of magical power and 4000 of HP. It's already a really good item. Because it will give her 10% more HP, nearly, little less. It's exactly what we need. The item, you can get it during the stage 13 and 18. It's the same like Vengeance Spirit. So, easy to get if you farm a while. And the item, now, Dark Shield. Dark Shield, when Skarla casts Magic Aid, so the blue skill, she can grant the whole team a Dark Shield. The shield's HP is based on her own intellect, so you have absorb up to 16,000 damage plus a bonus due to her own intellect. So I think it can change this hero a lot, and I prefer to recall you, Magic Aid. Sarah transfers part of her HP to the weakest ally, so I really think she can do something, we will see, because if she gets interrupted, if she dies quickly, it will not change nothing. So, let's begin the test. In this first test, we will see exactly what I was afraid. Enchantress will die in some second. Okay, she is meeting a crazy strong aggressive setup, but finally she was even not able to cast her blue skill, so she was just totally useless in this fight. Even if I win this match, it doesn't matter. We see that this hero actually has still this problem at red 3 when you are level 107. So perhaps after it will be better, but for the moment, it's not amazing. And if we are checking the statistics, 625,000 for Vengeance Spirit Legendary. So it confirms exactly what we saw in the first part of the video. This hero is just crazy. So now I will put Enchantress in one position where she can do something more interesting because all teams are not so aggressive than this one. For this second match, we will see what we can do, but I think she will be able to cast, at least. So this is the green skill. Oh, damage of Vengeance. Oh, this is the blue skill, but I don't understand one thing. It seems that she puts the shield only on her and Turtle Fighter. I don't know why, so we will have second chance. It will be now, if she don't kill... Oh, yeah, I will not have time. Okay, this time only on her. So, I don't understand the mechanic of this skill at all. We will do a last match to understand. Because in this situation, anyway, Vengeance Spirit killed everything. So, I will remove Vengeance Spirit and I will try again to see if we can get something more interesting. For this last test, I chose a team not really aggressive to see what she can do. But actually, you see the main problem. She can be interrupted by dragon, she can be interrupted. I think any attack that she will receive in the game will interrupt her, and finally we will lose a lot of efficiency of her first of her skill, of her legendary skill. Even if it seems that it can absorb some damage, finally she is too sensitive form control. Perhaps when she will be level 110 and when she will have 80-85,000 HP, it will be different. But actually, and sadly, if I can tell, she's not amazing. This skill didn't solve the problems that she had before, because she can't cast. And the second part of the problem is that when she casts the skill tells that she will put a shield on the whole team, and finally, I don't understand, but when I see 1-2 shield, it's the maximum, it's not the whole team. So perhaps we will win, but it doesn't matter, she did absolutely nothing. I will accelerate, okay, well, okay, 1 second to win, and if we check the statistic, no damage, no help, nothing, actually, really nothing. Finally, I can tell you that Vengeance Spirit legendary skill will be 100% interesting, whatever it will be, amazing or good, but it will not be bad for sure. More penetration armor on the item, more penetration armor with the skill, and more attack speed. It's just amazing for her. It's exactly what she was needed. So before she was good, now I think she will be really good. For Enchantress, unfortunately, what I was afraid, it's exactly what it is. She is not able to cast her skill due to her survivability. And finally, the legendary skill can be good or not. I don't know, because actually she cast it one, sometimes two times during the fight. It's like an ultimate, because any damage that she will receive, she will be interrupted, and it's a really pity. They have to rework her, not crazy much. If they put in training field 22,000 HP, it will already change her, and she will be able at least to cast her skill. And the second point for legendary skill, I don't think that it works properly, because like you can read, she must put a shield on whole team, and finally it never happened on whole team. It happens sometimes on one, sometimes on two, I think one times on three heroes, but most of the time between one and two heroes. So nothing really crazy. I hope that you will be able to do your choice after this little video. I did mine, you already get it. So it's now time to conclude. Thank you everybody for watching this video. Don't hesitate to subscribe, like and share to support my work if you enjoy it. See you soon for another video. Bye bye.